Hey guys, I'm Saurav, and in this video, let's talk about low light photography. So before talking about low light photography, let's understand what exactly low light is. Now the misconception is, generally shooting at night is low light photography, but it's not like that. You might be shooting in morning or in afternoon, but the place you're shooting at, maybe the light is not able to reach. So wherever the light is not enough, that is low light. And in low light photography, there are major two issues. The first issue is very obvious, that the images are too dark just because you don't have enough light to capture. The second issue is the images are too noisy. So maybe you shoot a dark image and you later go home and bump up the exposure, that might cause grains, or you bump up the ISO in camera to get the perfect exposure, that also might cause some noise and grains in the image, and you don't get that particular sharpness and quality in the images. So in this video, we will see how to deal with those situations and get sharp images and good quality even in low light. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So when you see the exposure triangle, you have three things. You have aperture, you have shutter speed, and you have ISO. Now for the time being, imagine you can't change the ISO and you can only deal with aperture and shutter speed. Firstly, let's talk about aperture. Now aperture, I have a separate video about it. So basically, if you use a wider aperture like f2.8, 1.8, so basically when you use a larger aperture, a wider aperture, you're allowing more light to come into the camera. So if you're shooting in low light, using a wider aperture will help you because you're allowing more light to enter the camera sensor. So this helps when you're shooting portraits or when you're shooting subjects which you want to be in focus, but you want the background to be blurred. So if you're not concerned with the background to be sharp and you want that narrow depth of field, you only want a particular subject in focus, then you can use this wider aperture. As in this example, you can see this image was taken at f10, and you can see the image is very grainy, but the same image if taken at f1.8 at the same shutter speed, I can lower down the ISO and the image is very clean. So that is the advantage when shooting with aperture. But just remember, again, if you're shooting with a wider aperture, you won't get everything in your image sharp because you're actually making the depth of field very less. So now let's talk about shutter speed. So basically, when you're talking about shutter speed, if you use a slower shutter speed, you are allowing more light to enter. If you're using a comparatively faster shutter speed, you're allowing less light to enter. So it's very obvious, right? In low light, if you use slower shutter speeds, you will get better exposed images. So for example, in this image, you can see this was taken at 1/30th of a second, and the same image when taken with 30 seconds of exposure, I can lower down the ISO and get the same perfect exposure with less grains and better image quality. So not only increasing the shutter speed, I mean increasing the shutter time using a slower shutter speed will allow more light to enter, but it will also remove any kind of motion blur. So if you're not concerned with the motion going on in your image or in the scene, then you can use slower shutter speeds. Again, there is a disadvantage to it. If you want to capture some motion, if you want to freeze any particular motion, you can't do that with lower shutter speeds, right? You have to use a comparatively faster shutter speed. So if you are in a situation where you want to capture a motion, where you want to freeze the motion, then you have to use a faster shutter speed. If you're shooting maybe handheld, then there is a chance of shaking the camera. Even that time, what you can do is you can use a shutter speed of maybe like 1/50th or 1/60th of a second. In that range, you might avoid the shutter shake or the shake of the camera that is produced by hand-holding the camera. So always remember that if you're on a tripod, if you are capturing a scene which is not having much movement, use a slower shutter speed. If you are in a scene where you want to capture motion, you are actually holding the camera with your hand and the chances are there of shaking the camera, use a slightly faster shutter speed. Now these are two basic solutions. The third solution is to combine a wider aperture and a slower shutter speed and get a perfect exposure. So as you can see here, I am actually holding the camera with my hand, so I can't use a very less shutter speed. I can't use a shutter speed of maybe 10 or 20 seconds. So I'm using a comparatively slower shutter speed and I'm using a comparatively wider aperture. So using a wider aperture and a slower shutter speed is allowing me to allow more light to come into the camera. So first of all, before adjusting this, switch to manual mode, okay? Everything we are talking about is in manual mode. So when you're combined the aperture and shutter speed, the last thing you have to adjust is the ISO. Now when you're adjusting ISO, just make sure the meter is at zero when you're taking the image, and that will ensure proper exposure. So to end this video, I will give you a small tip. If you're shooting in low light and if you're shooting at a lower ISO and getting a darker image, I would prefer to shoot at a higher ISO and get a properly decent exposure. Because when you're doing that, actually your camera sensor is doing all the hard work. But when you're using a software, basically you're telling the software to do all the hard work. And your camera sensor is much, much more capable than any other software in the market. So don't be afraid to increase the ISO, but always remember, if you have the flexibility of increasing the aperture, using a slower shutter speed, always try to experiment with those settings and then use the proper ISO to get a decent exposure, right? So I hope this video helped you guys, and the next time you shoot in low light, you come up with high quality images. If you like this video, press the like button, and if you loved it, press the subscribe button. I will talk to you guys in the next one. Bye.